Hi, I'm Anders.
I'm John.
Today we're going to be doing a discussion review of Rage.
This three-disc monster that is Rage. That is an adjective that you might have when you play the game. You might also rage quit after playing it. We're going to be talking about some of the problems with the game, some of the positives of the game, but mainly we're going to be discussing this review as partners because I'm a big Fallout fan, and Anders is a big Borderlands fan, and this is
I like
some.
Fallout too,
but... Yeah, he likes Fallout, but he's played Borderlands more than I have, and this is kind of a weird amalgam of both.
Pretty much both combined, basically, I mean, with some other additives, but it's basically Rage and Fallout.
But there's been a lot of.
I mean, Rage and Fallout. I'm sorry, Fallout and Borderlands.
Okay. Same thing.
Yeah, same thing.
Right? That's how interchangeable they are. There's been some. You know, hit or miss reviews for the game. Some people say it's amazing, some people say it's eh. Some people are like, what the hell is this game that I'm playing? So we're kind of going to give our spin on it, and we're going to address some of the things that people have had problems with to talk about how it's put together and whether or not it really deserves some of those reviews. So the story in Rage is that a massive meteor is coming towards Earth, and groups of people are put in these things called vaults. I mean, arcs. And, whoops! Bethesda couldn't think of a better word. So, you wake up in your vault. Everyone else has become mummified from cryogenic sleep, and you come out, and you do the traditional Bethesda, I've woken up into the sunlight, and I get blinded by the camera. And you're walking around, you get attacked, and you get saved by John Goodman. And John Goodman takes you to his town, and you help John Goodman out, and then he sends you to another town where you help them out, and then you find out what the story is. That's maybe about 6 hours into the game. And the story is essentially that these bad guys called the Authority, the Enclave, Brotherhood, it's the same thing, essentially. They are experimenting on the mutant tribes to try and make them soldiers, and they're also using this material called Feltrite to make super weapons to take over the world. So, it shouldn't have taken you that long to figure out what the story was. I mean, the entire time you're with John Goodman, you have no idea what's happening. And usually, in a Bethesda story, you find out immediately what the story is. Like in Oblivion, Patrick Stewart tells you, or the Emperor, tells you you have to find his son to, you know, get the line of the throne moving so that there's someone to rule the world. Fallout 3, Liam Neeson, your dad. It's just better to call them by their star names. It's so much cooler. You have to find him, which means then you have to, you know, save the water supply and get clean water to everyone in the capital wasteland. Fallout New Vegas, Colonel Ty from Battlestar Galacta. I can't remember his name for the life of me, but he's my favorite. He tells you where the guys who shot you in the head went, so you go to kill them, and then you meet Mr. House and everything like that. So you really do find out in the initial stages of learning how to play the game what the story is. And then in this one, you still don't know until after the first or second level of the game. So you have to kill a bunch of people for no reason other than, we need your help. You know, I'm going to be a good Samaritan. And that's the story.
Yeah, it's pretty much a carbon copy of Borderlands and Fallout. I mean, they're not even embarrassed to admit it. When you go to Wellspring for the first time, which is one of the first major towns that you visit, there's even a vault boy bobblehead on the corner of the mayor's desk that you can pick up. So they're not even disguising it. I mean,
I understand that they're trying to be subtle about it, but after a while I was like, really, this is just Fallout.
It's not even subtle.
Like, it's like the Fallout
it's
setup.
Like, it's not even subtle. As far as like them not really getting to the main plot point, I mean, I felt like I was kind of confused at first, but I was so taken with the graphics and the gameplay that, I mean, while like now looking back on it and seeing like, okay, I actually didn't even know what I was doing until about maybe like really what I was working for until about 5 hours into the game.
But what's weird, though, is I thought it was just a very big gamble for Bethesda and id to make that everyone's going to feel the same way you did. Yeah. That they're going to be taken by the graphics and the combat, and you're going to be so swept up in it that you won't think about the fact that you have no idea what you're doing.
Yeah.
And that's a big gamble that they're hoping the game that they've made is so good that you're going to overlook a major plot point. Mm-hmm. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2?
Yeah.
we all saw how that worked out. When it works, it works. But if a lot of RPG players play it, and they're ready, they're playing it because it's a Bethesda game, and they're thinking it's going to be like Fallout, or a lot of people who played Borderlands are playing it because they think it's going to be like Borderlands, you're going to be really confused. I mean, I play a lot of RPGs. That's kind of the main thing that I play. And I was upset that I had no idea why I was helping these people. Because I didn't care. I didn't care about anyone. I mean, like, after a while, I started to care about Wellsprings. And I just didn't feel like there was much motivation. All the mutant and gang attacks felt like a natural escalation of attacks. Yeah, they're going to poison your water supply because so far they haven't been able to do a full frontal assault on your town. That, to me, makes sense. But why do I care other than that?
From a first-person shooter perspective, the game is awesome.
Yeah.
It's absolutely awesome. I mean, it's from a story and RPG and motivation and perspective, it's definitely lacking.
Yeah, and so. I think that's one of the biggest gripes that people have had, especially RPG critics, are saying that it's lacking. It's not imaginative. It's very uninspired. And it is. It's very uninspired from what it is. It's a very big game. It's a very impressive game, but it doesn't really deliver story-wise. However, gameplay-wise, it is amazing. I mean, the crafting system is beautiful.
Yeah. And I mean, other than, what is it, the Dead City, you had to play that mission twice. And I'm like, are you serious? Like,
yeah, and it's hard to see it be so small when you're coming with the expectation that Bethesda makes large games. Bethesda, you know, the Fallout games are enormous. They are absolutely huge. But their towns are very small. Even Oblivion is like that. You look at, you know, Rage, the towns are very well sculpted and they're very
incredible.
Large.
When you walk through a town, you really, it's not like Fallout and that. It's
yeah, it's not three huts and a fence.
It's so much better than Borderlands or Fallout when you go into a town. It's like, you know, it's living, it's breathing, it's tangible. The characters, the animations are excellent. The graphics are even better. It's just, that whole situation is awesome. It's too bad that the story couldn't be as original enough and as engaging enough to really put those towns to good use. I mean, regardless, you're going to be taken away. You're going to be amazed by it. You're going to be taken by it. But you look back on it and you may see.
I think they were really good with their conversation system too. That talking to someone is just by looking at them. You know, there's no like, I'm going to talk to you, I'm going to click on you, and then we're going to have this conversation and everything else is going to stop around us. It's very much like if you're walking down the street and you don't pay attention to someone, they're going to be like, hey, all right, they're going to watch you walk away. I mean, if you turn around, you look at them, you get close to them, then they're going to talk to you. That makes sense because it does give you more of a connection. You have to pay attention to what they're saying. And I thought that was very clever. Some people didn't like that and some people do. I think it's a better compromise than the traditional Bethesda, hey, I'm going to talk to you and now I'm going to get really close to your face.
Yeah, and then so like we said before, the shooting mechanics and just general combat gameplay is amazing. While enemies will run towards you, the mutants are kind of like your zombies of Rage. They'll run towards you and they'll dodge left and right, making it really difficult to hit them. And when you fight the Authority, they're really skilled. They hide behind cover. And just generally, every single enemy that you fight has character. And it feels the animations feel tangible. The death animations look great. It feels when you hit somebody with a shotgun slug, they react accordingly and it seems realistic. And just everything about the combat is awesome. The ammo types also really vary the gameplay. When you fight Authority, you'll have to use certain rounds that will pierce through their armor. And when you fight mutants, you'll generally use the easier rounds because they're unarmored. So that really adds variety to the gameplay and really changes it up. We here at The Vault are giving Rage a 8 out of 10. We think it's an excellent game. The gameplay is awesome. The graphics are amazing, but the story is genuinely lacking. It would have received a higher score if they really delivered something new in that department and developed, you know, had better story development.
Well, that's going to do it for our review of Rage. For more news, reviews, and interviews, please go to facebook.com/gamecreatorsvault. We hope to see you there.